everyone, welcome back to my channel. Spring is just around the corner and I have a palette just for you that you will enjoy during the spring months. It is the Tarte Be Matnificent Amazonian Colored Clay Matte Collector's Palette. Isn't this just beautiful? It has a purple like gem, like from the stones that you open up, sometimes there's gems inside. Beautiful outer packaging. Gold also. It is plastic. These shades, they're all matte. The blush, the shadows, the eyeliners, everything is matte. And this look right here is actually created from it. This palette is a beautiful palette, and I can see why they call it the collector's palette. Inside, not only are there six eyeshadows, but there's also a blush and two eyeliners. Look how beautiful that is. And of course, all these can be used interchangeably. You know, you can use these as shadows as well. Probably the blush you can use it as well. And then there is a gorgeous ginormous mirror so you can do your makeup on the go. These shadows and everything in here, they are all matte, which is nice. I find that the consistency of the shadows are creamy, yet at the same time it's a little bit dry. I'm guessing that's because of, you know, the matte of it. But the most driest one is this one here, and as well as two eyeliners are very on the drier side. The rest of them are very creamy, as well as the blush. So let me give you a little rundown of the different names of it. The blush is called Elated, and it's a very pretty like rosy kind of blush, and I have it on right here. Kind of similar, I want to say, to Tarte Exposed. So if you've been wanting Tarte Exposed, you've got it similar right here. Probably a little bit more on the pinkier rosy side than what Exposed is. Alright, so the first one you have is Stand Out from the Crowd, which is a creamy, slightly yellow shade right here. Next you have Peach for the Stars, and you wouldn't think that this would be peach. This seems more of a burnt brownish peach. When I think of peach, I think of, you know, like a lighter version of a coral. Then this one here is a Two Plums Up. As you can see, it's a plummy color. This one here is View from the Taupe, which is a pretty taupe color. This one is Rose to the Occasion, so it's a little bit darker than the blush, but it's still on the rosy side. And then this light pink one is Pink Outside the Box, which is a very light baby pink. And then this one is Dream in Chocolate. This is one of the liners. And this is Don't Stand Black. And it also comes with this little brush here. It has like a flat kind of shader, even though it's not a shade, like a flat one. And then this crease side is a little crease brush. I haven't used this crease yet. I've used this, and it's okay. It doesn't pack on as much color as I had hoped. That's why I used my other brush instead. And then also included is this little index card, and it has the beauty guru Holly Annery. I don't know how to pronounce your name, I'm sorry. And it gives two looks of what she liked from this palette. The first one is called Your Moment in the Sun, and it's a more of a natural look, and it gives you instructions and what colors to use, and it has little numbers to kind of tell you where to place it. The next one is a more dramatic style, and this is Reach for the Stars. And you can see it's definitely more of a dramatic nighttime look. Let me show you the swatches really quick before you see how to get this look. You have Stand Out from the Crowd, which is considered a base. Then you have Peach for the Stars, which is good for a lid color. Next you have Two Plums Up, and this is considered your outer corner. Then over here you have Pink Outside the Box, which is for the lid. Here is Rose to the Occasion, which is a crease color. And the other crease color is View from the Taupe. So you can see that they all blend gorgeously together. And then the liners, this is Dream in Chocolate. This is Don't Stand Black. And then here is the gorgeous blush. And of course you can see it here. So if you want to keep watching, see how I got this look. I have a little surprise at the end of the video if you want to check that out. I've already primed my eyelids with the Lorac Behind the Scenes Primer. This is the deluxe size that I got with my Lorac Unzipped palette. By the way, this is the Urban Decay shadow one that I got in my Urban Decay Naked palette. We're going to use this little one for the base because supposedly this sand out from the crowd. And see, it's very powdery. See that? Very, very powdery. This is going to be the base, so let's put it up here. Next, I'm going to take Rose to the Occasion, which is this beautiful one right here, and put that inside the crease. I'm using my Coastal Scents fluffy brush and just applying this to the crease. Next, we're going to take the outer V corner, which is two plums up. See how dark and beautiful that one is? Very beautiful. Blend, blend. I'm going to take the sand from the crowd and put it in my crease here to smooth out the edges as well as highlight the brow. I'm going to take this little tiny smudge brush and I'm going to line. I think I'm going to use a mixture of black and brown. So let's start off with the brown and then go to black. This is to smoke it up. And kind of bring it into the outer V. So now you're going to take your little blender again, a different blender. And then again, softly, we're just going to pat on a little bit more of that pink outside the box and kind of pat it on a little bit more. Just kind of brighten it up a bit here. Just take, I guess, the taupe mixed with Rose to the Occasion, put it underneath. On this, the thin brush, and take Peach for the Stars and just put a little bit kind of like right here, warm it up a bit. And now we're going to use the blush. So I'm going to take my blush brush, take Elevated. It's a beautiful rosy color. And to top off the look, of course, you want to apply mascara. Okay, so if you've made it this far, I'm glad you enjoyed the video, and now it's time for my little surprise. Ready? Here he comes. Here is my little baby! I just got him a few weeks ago, and he's a little dachshund, and his name is Copper. He is 3, almost 4 months old. Say hi. Hope you enjoyed this video. We'll see you later. Bye.